You right? You ready?
Oh, that's a long shot down there. Holy dude.
Hello.
Oh my goodness. Thanks for your help. I'd have been stuck down there for hours. So you might recognize this one from quite a few years ago in a video where we were cutting opal with kids, and it was a pretty funny one, wasn't it? This kid is just, he can't help himself. Every time the camera goes on record, he's gone. Anyway, we'll get him on the machine a little bit later, but what we should start with children is a very big piece. This is just a joke, dude. Start, shush. Hopefully that doesn't happen again this time. So, what we're going to do today... Sorry, just brought me back to that time. What we're going to do today is we are going to go through a beginner parcel that I have, and Saxon's going to go through with me tutoring him, and we're going to do some shaping before we actually start to cut some of the bits of colour. So firstly, we're going to sort out which pieces are potch and which pieces are colour. The sorting only takes a few minutes, but look very carefully because sometimes you can see hidden colour. So what we're going to do to begin with is you're going to flatten out one side so that we can get so we can draw a shape on it. Okay, mm-hmm. Let's do that. So get the machine going. Water on. When working with a piece of potch, don't be shy. It's not worth anything, but it is the same density as a beautiful opal, so you can practice as much as you want on this type of opal. Alright, that looked good. So... So now... Shush! So now, the next step for us to do is and you don't do this on the opal that has the colour necessarily, you can, but just as a guide for you to begin with, we're going to draw a nice oval onto this piece that Saxon's smoothened out, okay? So I'll even get you to do it if you want to do an oval in some area there.
Good idea.
So we've got a jelly bean. I reckon you could make that a lot bigger on that stone.
Alright.
So let's try that. Just go a little bit wider. It doesn't matter about the pen because it will come off. But you can make that much, much bigger. Even bigger. Go wider. So it doesn't matter if you make mistakes with the pen because you can just keep going over it and over it. But that gives you a kind of a guideline. It's not really that great, but once you start shaping it, you'll see where the bumps and lumps are to be reshaped. So, all right. So that looks good. We've shaped it, we've drawn it up, and we're gonna go now back on the wheel and give it a quick shape. Now, Saxon's done this a few times, so we might miss a few parts of it, and he might go straight to the colour once he's shaped this one up. So let's have a crack and see how we go. Using two hands to steady yourself, you will have an easier time shaping the piece. If you feel like doing other shapes also, you can do whatever shape you like. I just like to do ovals, and they're the easiest way to start. But you can do cushion cuts or triangles or whatever the opal actually is telling you that it wants to be. Sometimes you can cut an opal to the shape of what it is, and it can be even a free form. It's totally up to you. I'm just choosing ovals because that's what I like. So you can see Saxon's actually using his both of his hands to steady the stone on the wheel, which is really important. You can't just use one and muck around, because it's you're not going to get the same control as you do with two. So that's the first starting point, is with the two hands you get control. So let's keep at it. The preform shape doesn't have to be perfect, because you can fine shape the piece once it's on the dopstick, but it does help with an even dome to make it easier when you're cutting it. You should have a few pieces of colour to cut if you make a mistake on the first one, which can and probably will happen your first go around.
Maybe I should do this.
You can do an oval, yep, just that size is fine. And then from there you can shape it to a nice oval after.
The second time around, Saxon was more confident, had a better feel for the wheels, and holding the stone correctly in his hands made all the difference. So many people ask me, how do you know how far to go before you lose the colour? And the answer to that is practice. The more you begin to understand opal, the better and faster you will be able to cut with confidence. Also, knowing when to stop and when to use the fine wheels as opposed to the rough ones that will leave deep scratches in your stone. Roughing out is the most important part of the process, and if you're not sure, stop, put the piece down and walk away. Come back with fresh eyes. It usually helps to make better decisions.
All right, so now Saxon's rubbed out the opal. Now it's close enough. It's not quite as a professional would do it. It's not quite good enough to be, a top gemstone, like $1,000 or $2,000 gem. But in this case, when it's only like a $20 to $50 stone, it's okay. So we're ready to try and put this on the dopstick now, and Saxon can do it and see if he doesn't burn his fingers. This is gonna be funny. Alright.
Burn yourself. Okay, so is that dopstick got enough wax above it? Have you pushed all that wax above?
Yeah, I have.
You have. Okay. Alright, so I would heat the stone first because the wax melts and drips. So, yep, take it out. Take it out, leave it out for a bit. That's too long. Oh my goodness, it's gonna drip. Heat the stone, not the wax. Heat the stone a little bit more. I should do it. Okay, now you're wet. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh my goodness, you're going to break it.
I didn't push up far enough.
No, what happened was you just heated the wax too much and it just fell back down. Just put it through the flame a couple of times. Like, that's it. And then take it out. And then one more time. Put it in. Okay, now heat the wax up. That's it. And that's probably about enough. So now turn the stone so it's facing upwards and then put the dopstick. That's the opposite way around, but anyway, okay. Now, let go with the tip, this, yep. And now you need to wet your fingers and squeeze that on. That's it. And try and push all the wax underneath the stone so it's not showing out on the sides. This is something that most people do wrong, is they actually get too much wax on the edges of the opal, and then when it comes to polishing the sides, the wax gets in the way. So it's really important to push all that wax underneath. How's it going? Yeah, it's getting there. Pretty close. Alright, let's show our viewers at home. Now you can see that this opal is sitting on there, but when you turn it round and round, it's actually a bit wonky on the stick. So you have to make sure that that's centered, like you're doing on a lathe. You have to make sure that that stone is quite centered. So this wax is still a bit malleable, so I can move it around. And I've just moved it over, and you can see now it is quite straight. So there we go. We can start cutting the stone on the machine. You're right there playing with fire. As usual, let's play with fire, Dad.
So now we start by shaping first. Mm-hmm. So you need to hold the opal this way and look over the top of it and get your shape right, okay? That's what you gotta do. That's it. Try and get a perfect oval as you can.
The polishing part of the process is very time consuming. To make sure that you get all of the abrasions out of the stone before you decide to polish is very, very painstaking sometimes. Taking your time and being patient will pay off. To see that final polish on the gem is very rewarding, especially when you're cutting nice color.
All right, so this is a great experiment to show you how tough it is, if you're not an opal cutter and you're trying to learn, how tough it is to get a good polish. And I can show you with this one with Saxon, I can guarantee that he hasn't spent quite enough time on it to be able to get that really, really high polish. So you do need to spend more time than you think to get it to a really nice gemstone state. Hey, that's not bad. Now I'll show you guys up close in the macro lens, all the scratches and marks that are left on the stone, because it's just there's not enough time spent on those wheels to get down those abrasives. So I can see there is on the edges, can you see this? There's all these smudges and cutting marks, okay?
Yeah.
And can you see in that's the centre?
Yeah, I saw that in the centre, there's a little scratch. Yeah.
So that means that you would, if you were wanting to do a perfect job, you want to go back to the wheels beforehand and take those spots out before you go back to the polish again, because it just takes a lot of effort to get those actual scratches out. So don't give up if you're feeling like you're not getting that polish quite straight away. Don't give up, because it does take time, and every time you have a go at another piece of opal, you will get better and better every time. It takes practice. So how'd you enjoy that?
It's good.
Yeah, what did you enjoy about it? Pyro,
all of it, I guess.
You enjoyed the fire?
Yeah, the fire was good.
Yeah, he likes holding tweezers. And he likes doing hairdos like mine. Dad jokes again. Well, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. That was a bit of fun. And we'll see you next time.